So I got the chance to sit down with you a little, what, 4 or 5 months ago, right before Spider-Man shipped. And that, as a lot of us had suspected, turned into a very, very big deal for you guys, for the industry, for Marvel. How has life been since Spider-Man shipped?
Calm. It probably would have been a lot less calm had it not been very well received by the fans. So we were really humbled and honored to get the response that we did. And I think most of us now have had experiences where we've talked to a fan about Spider-Man and their experiences playing either by themselves or with friends or with family. And it sort of validates what we were going for, which was to deliver a positive message and to tell a story that people would really identify with.
By any metric you choose, I mean, is it Insomniac's most successful game ever, or a studio with a decorated history?
Yeah, it is. I mean, we've been very proud of all the games we've made, and I mean, from the beginning, even Disruptor, like our very first game, just getting that game out the door was a major accomplishment for us. And then moving to Spyro, where we completely shifted gears, and then Ratchet, which had a lot of firsts for us. And the list goes on. There was Resistance, Sunset Overdrive, all of our VR games. We learned something on every single game. And so for us, while this game has been tremendously successful, and we owe a ton of gratitude to Sony and Marvel, our partners on it, for us, we learned a ton. And I think it's helped us evolve even further as a studio in terms of our ability to take on bigger, more complex games, because we had to grow, not just in terms of our size, but in terms of our systems and production processes during Spider-Man.
Give me an example. Like what, you know, because I'm sure you guys by now have done a thorough postmortem on Spider-Man internally. What, you know, and obviously it was a huge success critically and commercially. What are maybe one or two of the big kind of big picture takeaways that you'll apply to the next project for the team?
Well, to be fair, we are still doing postmortems. And so there was a lot to talk about in terms of how we what we liked and what we didn't like about the game's production. So I think one key takeaway was we need to have efficient pre-productions, more efficient pre-productions. And that means knowing what the pillars are very early, knowing which game systems we really need to build, knowing what matters and what doesn't matter, and what questions we can leave until later. Those are things that we've now identified much more clearly in terms of how what's key when we attack the next big game.
Well, has the studio huge success here of Spider-Man, has it changed life at Insomniac in any way, either I'd assume for the better?
Yeah, I mean, I think we're all happy that it's been a success. And whenever you have a successful game, whether it's sales-wise or ratings-wise or fan response-wise, it gives you confidence, right? And so I think we as a studio have even more confidence to take on the same kinds of challenges we face as the industry evolves. And as we look ahead, no question that what players want continues to evolve as well. They want bigger games, more complex stories, better meshing between narrative and game design. So we have more confidence to take creative risks and try different things.
It's funny, I had Amy Hennig in that same chair earlier today. And she was talking about how, you know, we got onto the topic of single player games, of which Spider-Man obviously is. And she actually had mentioned Spider-Man as an excellent recent example. And but she made an interesting point, I thought, about how you know, something like a Red Dead Redemption 2, as brilliant as it is, being a 40-ish hour game just on the single player side, let alone all the side stuff, is a little, as a storyteller for her, it's oh, you know, that's a challenge, because it's like, how many of your players are going to see through that story to the end? So do you, gamers seem to want, or say they want bigger and better and more, but, you know, do you have to kind of be careful at Insomniac to not bloat your next game too much, and to try to maintain that focus on telling a story that everybody will really enjoy all of?
I think it's more about making sure that the game design serves the story and vice versa. So as no matter what you're doing in the game, if it feels like it's somehow connected to who the characters are, what their emotional challenges are going through the game, and not something that's tacked on, that's for us the goal. And did we succeed in Spider-Man in doing that consistently? No, we didn't. I mean, I think some of our side content feels a little bit detached, and I think that those are that's an area we can improve. And the fans called it out. And that's the kind of feedback that we like to get, because we want to know what players liked and what players didn't. And it gives us something to work on as well. So in terms of overall time in the game and how big games need to be, I think every game is different. And it really depends on what the kind of the expectations you're creating for fans, right? If you, there are some franchises out there that already have expectations that have been set,
right?
And so if you deliver if your franchise has been typically 40 plus hours and you deliver one that's 15 hours long, then yeah, you got a problem.
That's a good point.